Starting.
Okay, ברוך השם. משה, do you hear me?
Yes, Rabbi.
Okay, ברוך השם. Good. So with the help of Hashem, we're starting הלכות טרפות, סימן נון וו, paragraph וו. Okay? So the subject matter that we're dealing with is the tendons, okay, gidim, of the animal. And we said yesterday specifically the tendons of the back legs, okay? And we saw yesterday that the stringency is going like from the high point of the leg where it's connected to the body and goes down to the direction of the hoofs, but with one exception, which is Tzomet HaGidim, where the tendons are coming together and then they split from there. So that Tzomet HaGidim place is the bottom of the leg and it is very stringent. Okay, so this is the subject matter we're dealing with. Says the Shulchan Aruch in paragraph Vav. יש גידים אחרים שנבלעים אלו באלו כזכרים בנקבות ואותם אינם בכלל צומת הגידים. So we have to understand that sometimes you have the between the tendons you have one string that goes into another string. Yeah? So the one that is the main one that is going in the Tzomet HaGidim, this is the stringency. But the one that goes into it, it doesn't have the same rule, doesn't have the halakha like Tzomet HaGidim. Okay? Paragraph Zayin. Tzomet HaGidim בבהמה גימל אחד גימל, אחד אב ושניים דקים. So by animal, the Tzomet HaGidim is really three tendons. One is thick and two are thin. Okay? שניים דקים. נחתך האב לבדו מותרת. If only the thick one got cut, the animal is permitted. שרי נשארו שניים, because there were two left. נחתכו השניים הדקים מותרת. If the two got cut, it is permitted. שרי האב גדול משניהם, because the thicker one is bigger than both of them. והרי לא ניטל כל הצומת, כל הצומה. So it means that not all of the tendons of the Tzomet HaGidim were taken in this case. אלא מיותר, just a little bit of it. נחתך רובו של כל אחד מהם, if the majority of each one of them have been cut, טרפה, that's already טרפה. Even though none of them have been cut completely, still it's trefa. Okay? There is a Bayreitev Dalet here, Miuto. Katav Ashach, Deyesh Lifso Kerashi, Bebema, Nami Trefa. So the Shach says, we have to say the Alecha like Rashi, that by animal it will be trefa because of the doubt. Rov echad mehem, because of the majority of one of them. Meroi lehechmir beisur deoraita, and we have to be stringent because it is forbidden, deoraita prohibition. Ayin bataz shema'arich belashon arosh veleika nafkuta ledina. So look in the taz that is length about the words of the Rosh to explain them, but really there's no result, practical result for that. Anyhow, the point of the matter is that we have a machloket rishonim of what does it mean the majority that makes the animal to be trefa. So the Shulchan Aruch took the side of the Rambam, that he says that you have to be the majority of all of the attendants. But the Shach says that according to Rashi, it could be majority of one attendant of the tree. And he says, the writer, it's affect the writer. So you have to be stringent, okay? Let's see the Rama. אגיד, האב הוא אותו שמפרידים כשתולין הבהמה. The thick tendon from the tree is the one that they separate when they are hanging the animal. Okay? So, I don't know if you ever saw that, but when they doing the, when they are working on the animal to remove the skin, to open the animal to get to the lungs, to check the lungs and so on, all of that. Usually the way they do that is that they are hanging the animal. So how they hang the animal, they put a hook or string in that place next to the hoof, which is the Tzomet HaGedim, and they are hanging the animal from that thick tendon of the tree. That's what the Rama says. That's the custom of all of the butchers, all of the shochatim, that when they're working on the animal, they're hanging the animal from that. So, by the way, you see how strong it is, that one tendon is holding all of the weight of the animal. It's not getting torn. It's very, very strong. Okay? So he says, "Hu munach al hashnayim ve'em dvukim habasar u'ba'etzem." So that thicker one, thicker tendon, is placed on the two, and they are connected to the leg of the animal. So let's say you have the leg, you have the two tendons, the thicker one, and then you have the third one. Yeah. So the two are on the leg, and the thicker one sticks out a little bit. So when they want to hang the animal, they put the hook between them, between the two to the one, and then they hang it from here. Yeah, that's the way they do it. That's the classical way to do it. Anyhow, there's no baritev here, right? Yeah. Okay. Paragraph chet. Be'of em ba'etzem ha'emtza'i kmo ba'be'ema. Birds have more than three. They have 16 tendons, okay? So all of the tendons, all the Tzomet HaGedim by chicken is right there in the bone next to the end of the leg, okay? V'im nusak rubo shel echad mehem trefa. So there, also the Shulchan Aruch, according to the Rambam, he also says that cutting majority of one of them will make the chicken to be, the bird to be trefa, we forbidden. Okay? So by birds, everybody agrees that majority of one is stringent. Ted? Siman makom shekalim tzomet hagedim ba'of kesimanam bebema daka. To recognize where is the end part of those tendons, that it's not so stringent from there onwards, it is like the animal, like by excuse me, like Behema Daka, like by Behema Daka, the same thing is by birds. Says the Rama, בכל מי שבקי לשער יוכל לשער בכל עוף לפי גודלו לפי קטנו. Okay, when you know where is it by birds, so it doesn't matter what is the size of the bird. You have the ratio between the bigger, smaller birds, and you know how, like, where is the stringent part of the tendons and where is the lenient part of the tendons. כל הזמן שהם קשים, אבי צומת הגדים. So generally, the rule is when the tendons are hard, so then it is more stringent because this is part of the צומת הגדים. כמו שמתרחקים, when the tendons are getting to be soft, so then לא אבי צומת הגדים, so then that's not צומת הגדים, and then you can be more lenient. That's the general rule. ומי שאינו בקיא לשער, ישער ברוחב אצבע בעוף ממקום שמתחילים. Okay, somebody that is not knowledgeable, doesn't have the experience, so how can he measure? So it says the Rama, measure with the thickness of your finger. Yeah, the thickness of the finger, it's like that. Yeah. From the place where they are starting, and then outside of that range, it will be not so mitagidim. ולעולם אין צומת תגידים למעלה מחצי העצם האמצעי. You will always find that the צומת תגידים is not continuing after the middle of the bone. The middle bone. So we said that we have the, in the leg, we have three bones, right? The one that is connected to the body, that's the hip. You have the middle one, which is the shin. And you have the low one, which is the hoof. Or the leg of the chicken. So the middle one, the shin. So halfway up in the shin, it cannot be, like after that, for sure, it's not Tzomet HaGidim anymore. Usually it will not get there, but after half of that, for sure, it's not Tzomet HaGidim. Okay? ואיננו בקיאים בגדיגת צומת הגידים. Okay, that's a very important line to know. The Rama says, we don't know how to do the checking of the צומת הגידים of birds, ושל עוף, משום זה קשה לבדוק, because it's difficult to check. ובקל ונטרף, it's very easy to look at it and to say that it's that then that the bird is forbidden. לכן בכל מקום, דאיקה מכה במקום צומת הגידים. So if there is the animal, the chicken, the bird, got hit in the place of the צומת הגידים, אפילו אינו רק נפוח, even if it is a little bit puffed, a little bit like a swollen, נצרר אדם, and you have, how do you call that, blood, when, no, when there's a, like a bruise.
Scab?
Not scab.
Or congealed?
Congealed. When the blood is getting congealed there, מאחר שהיה צריך בדיקה ואין לנו בקיאים בעוף וטרפה, so because it needs to be checked, and we don't know how to check it, so you have to be stringent and to say that chicken is forbidden, okay? But, so one thing is the stringency that the Rama brings, but another thing is that you see that the Rama says that we don't know how to check the Tzomet HaGidim. Okay? So there is people, there is rabbis, not people. There is rabbis, big rabbis, that they say what the Rama said was true in his times. But today, because the chickens are not healthy, we have to check Tzomet HaGidim. For every chicken we're doing Shechita. Even though there was no heat, wound, all of those things, that doesn't matter, we have to check, okay? But the Rama says, we don't know how to check. Okay, but we have to check, anyhow.
Then what do they check for?
Okay, good question, but that's what they do. Okay, it's a big argument. It's between the different Hechsherim, there's a big argument, and there is people that they would say, I don't eat this Hechsher because they don't check Tzomet HaGidim. And so on and so forth, all kinds of statements like that. Yeah. I don't want to eat from this rabbi Shechita because he doesn't check the Tzomet HaGidim. So if you learn those halachot, so you know that the Rama says we don't know how to check. So those that they say that they know how to check, so what they're saying? They're saying that they are smarter than the Rama, they have more experience than the Rama. Okay, good for them. What can I say? Baruch Hashem. Anyhow, let's go backwards a little bit and do the Beritev. We skipped over. Beritev Hey. So we said the thickness of a finger, right? So the Beritev says Agudal. Which finger? The thumb. It's not the, so it's a little bit more than the finger. Yeah, the thumb. You have to check by the thickness of the thumb. Fine. Agudal of a shiuro, Nibel Il Simanun Daled. כתב רשא לדלידן צריך באוף על כל פנים רוחב בית אצבעות. So the Rashal wrote that for us we have to be stringent for two fingers. Okay? Two fingers. So what does it mean again? From the place where you see that the Tzomet HaGedim, you see the tendons that are sticking out. So from there you have to check two fingers thickness, or like this, according to the what he was saying before, that he's talking about the thumb, and then like up the leg of the chicken, and then from there onwards it's not Tzomet HaGedim anymore. So even though there was a problem there, but it doesn't make the chicken to be forbidden necessarily. Okay? Now, Be'erit Vav, Lemala, Katav HaShach, V'Shach Poskim, Ze'al Zeh Yechol Kol Adam Lismoch, V'Shiur Zeh Ben Be'of Katan Ben B'ma Gdola. Okay, so when we were speaking about half of the shin, the height of half of the shin, the Tzomet HaGedim laws doesn't go above that. So the Shach says anyone can recognize where is the half of the shin. So that's something that you can say it will be true anywhere, by birds, by animals, anywhere, anything that you'll take, you can like see where is the half of the shin, and if it is above that, so you don't have a problem. If it's below that, so then you might have a problem and you have to ask a rabbi that is expert. Anyhow. נשבר העצם מחצי עצם האמצעי ולמעלה, אין לחוש לפסיקת הגדין. So the result of that will be that if the bird or the animal broke the leg in the upper half of the shin, you don't have to worry about the tendons. Yeah, you have to worry about other things, but not tendons. Vimor basar chofim et ruba akshara. So if you have skin and flesh that are covering the majority of it, so then it will be kosher, like we learned before. Vim chazar v'nikshar af al pi she'en hashvarim yirda v'dubaku, yesh le'akel be'etzem ze. And if it got healed, that broken bone, so even though it was not the good healing, like we explained yesterday, so you don't have like that, it is like one piece on the other, exactly, a little bit tilt, whatever, you can be lenient. Okay? Be'eritev Zayin, Nafuach, Katav HaShach B'Shem Ha'Arshal, אבל מכל מקום, הכל לפי הנפוח. וצריך המורה קודם שיטריף לחתוך הניפוח. So when there is a swollen place because of wound or because of heat, so it is something that it might be a problem and it might be fine. So you have to know, or to yourself, or to go to ask a rabbi that is expert in that. So usually what the rabbi will do, that's what the Baritah brings from the Shach, is to cut open that swollen place in the leg of the animal or the chicken and to see what's in there. Okay? So it says, then it says in the brackets, שאם נראה מתוך הנפוח שיש בו ריקבון ונימוח, יש לחוש שנפסק אחד מחוטין, אז יש לאסור ולהטריף.
Another thing after this, okay? Obviously, whoever is not capable is not capable. You know, each one.
Okay, Baruch Hashem. I don't know how it happened. A different recording. Anyhow, again, the rabbi that is cutting like halfway, like the swollen place. Cutting half, you have to look inside. If you see inside that it's starting to get rotten, or like the meat inside is not healthy, it's like stinky, it doesn't look good, so then that will be a sign or that there's something really wrong there, and there's a good chance that one of the tendons got cut off or damaged. And then we have to be stringent to say it is forbidden. Now, Bach Katav, the law Amar, Arav Rama, and a Nafuch. Aval Bishinui Mare, לחוד. If so, the Bach says what the Rama said is about the swollen place in the leg, but if it just have a different look, okay, doesn't look good, but it's not swollen, there's no blood congealed, so then there is a possibility to be lenient. Gon brilin gla blue, okay, all kinds of Yiddish words. Kai gavna en shum lakuta velo nafuach machshirin legamrei. So if there is no really heat and no swollen parts, so we can be totally lenient and to say it is permitted. כן כתב עטרת זהב, דווקא כשנצרר הדם הרבה, עד שכמעט אין הגידים ניכרים מפני הדם, אבל צרורות דם מועט, למה נטריף? שאין רואים שום ריאות בגידים. So the עטרת זהב is explaining that in any heat you have like a certain amount of blood congealed. So if it is something that is minor and you see the tendons that they didn't get damaged, so then you can be lenient. But when the, what is the blood congealed that the Rama was speaking about, when it, there is a lot of blood congealed and you don't see the tendons, what's going on with them there, then you have to be stringent. Okay. מכל מקום צריך לתת לזה שאלות וחקירת חכם ירא אפילו בזמננו. Okay, so he says that you have to or be an expert yourself or to bring it to an expert to decide. Because it like to decide what is the level of that specific case, if it is something that you have to be stringent or you can be lenient about it. Okay. Chet. No, that's the second, the next paragraph. Okay, paragraph Yud of the Shulchan Aruch. Nishbar ha'etzem b'mekom tzomet ha'gidim. If the bone have been broken in the place of the, where the tendons are, the tzomet ha'gidim, or the tendons, nikshar v'nitrape yafeh. So then after that, the broken bone have healed itself, and it's good. יש מתירים אם לא נשתנה מראית הבשר שעל השבר, ויש עוצרים עד שיבדוק צומת הגידים. So the Shulchan Aruch, there is those that are lenient, as long as you don't have a different look to the flesh, the meat, that is surrounding the broken bone. And there is those that are stringent, unless he will check the צומת הגידים. Okay? says the Rama, וכן עיקר לדידן, דהן הנובקים. So, this is the main הלכה, and we don't know exactly how to check it. בדיקת העוף, טריפה. So, by chicken, it will be forbidden because of that. Okay? בערב חט, טריפה, כתב השח ולא דם מלעיל, סימן ונבב, סעיף י"ב, ואם נתרפא, שבר השבר, דקשר. So, the Shach says, it is not similar to what we were discussing before, that when it is healed, the broken bone is healed properly, it will be kosher. דהתם, הוא שלא במקום צומת הגידים. Because there in Siman Nunhei, we spoke about a broken bone in a different place, not in Tzomet HaGidim. Okay? And here we're talking about Tzomet HaGidim, so it is much more stringent. Atrifut Tolui B'Yitziat HaEtzem. So there in Siman Nunhei, the whole prohibition comes in when the bone sticks out. Yeah, when the bone is getting revealed there. So then it becomes to be stringent. Here, so then, if it got healed, so it will be kosher. מה שאין כנחה, דאיקה למיכה של פסיקת אחד מהגידים. But here, because we're talking about the צומת הגידים, except of the problem of the broken bone, we have the fear that the tendons got damaged, and that will be the reason to forbid. כל זה באופן, ובמה מעני בדיקה, דווקא כשחזר ונקשר. אבל אם עדיין שבור, כיוון דה עיקריות הגדולה, יש לעסוק גם בממה. So then he says that by animal, you can check the Tzomet Agidim, and if there was no damage, so you can be lenient. By chicken, because the, according to the Rama, we don't know how to check, so we have to be stringent to say that the bird is forbidden. And he, and then he says also by animal, if you can check if the broken bone got healed, but if it's still broken, so then you have to be stringent also by animal. Okay, so even if you'll check and you'll it will seem that really there's no problem in the Tzomet Agidim by animal, still it will be forbidden because there is a broken bone.
So that's a reyusa, right?
Yeah. It's more than a reyusa, it's for prohibition. Yeah.
See the Rama who says that you don't know how to do it. So why is it even permitted according to each chicken then? Is it something that has to be checked or?
Again, according to the Rama, if nothing happened to that chicken, you don't have to check.
Okay.
And when you do have to check, you don't know how to check, so you have to say it's forbidden. Yeah.
Oh, it's meaning don't even check it because we don't know.
When you need to check.
Yeah. Ah. Okay.
Because you don't know how to check, you have to be stringent to say it is forbidden.
Okay.
Yeah.
But from the start, if there's no reason to check it, like there's no reason that.
Right. So that's a machloket. What I said.
Right.
The according to Rama, you don't have to check.
Okay.
When there's no reason to, but there is more than rabbis. More than like today, like our generation rabbis, that they want to say that the chickens today, you have to check every chicken, some of the gedim, even though there's no real, that there's nothing happened there, because the chickens are not healthy, and many times you have problems there. Yeah. So that's a big argument in the like the politics around the shechita, that like
have they found issues and things like that.
Yeah, for sure.
But according to the Rama, they don't even know how to check, right?
Okay, so that's the argument. That's part of the argument. Yeah, I agree. It's very, very difficult. The argument is difficult argument. Maze? Shh. Why? Wow. Toda rabba. Kol hakavod. Baruch Hashem. In that merit, Bezrat Hashem, she will grow up to be a big tzaddeket and to merit Talmid Chacham. Bezrat Hashem. Baruch Hashem. And we will have, like those cases came here, that Hashem will send us all the abundance and all the salvations that we need. Everything will be sweet and good.
Amen.
Bezrat Hashem. Okay, so basically we finished the Siman. We finished Nun Vav. Right, so we have a seal. You can say mezonot. Okay, Baruch Hashem. While you're saying mezonot, I will saw the next siman. Ma? Bezrat Hashem, shitkabel haseminar, everything will come good. Bezrat Hashem. Okay, so I'm starting siman nun zayin. You can say borem mezonot, no problem. Okay, siman nun zayin. Din be'ema drusa michaya doreset. Okay, so this siman nun zayin is talking about animal that got attacked by prey animal. Okay. Drusa perush adrisa iyakaa sheka achaya or off b'tziponayim. Trefa. Okay, drusa is one of the kinds of the trefot. If you remember. In the beginning of Halachot Trefot, we had the siman of Dan Hanak Nefesh. Yeah. So there the one like the Dalet is Drusa.
Yeah.
Right? So Drusa, it means not any attack. It's specifically attack with the nails. Okay. When the prey animal is scratching with the nails. According to the sages, okay, and I know that scientifically it doesn't hold, but I guess we have to say that there's something spiritual about it. But according to the sages, all the prey animals have some kind of a poison in their nails, okay? And therefore, when they are scratching with their nails, it makes a very, very harsh effect that the animal become to be trefa. Okay? So it's not any attack, meaning if it is by the teeth, no, we don't say that. Tursa is only with the nails. And then the Shulchan Aruch continues. לא כל חיה ואוף שווים בדריסתן. אלא מעלות מעלות יש. There's many, many levels to those הלכות of דרוסה. כיצד? How so? הארי יש לו דריסה אפילו בשור הגדול ובגסה שבחיות. So a lion or a prey animal that is like a big tiger that is like a lion, like the biggest prey animals, they can make any animal to be drusa, meaning even a big ox, giant ox, if a lion scratched it, it becomes to be trefa. Okay? Ze'ev, a wolf, again, it's the size of the wolf. It can be a different animal, but the same size, which is one less than the lion. אין לו דריסה במגסה, אפילו בקטנה שבהם. כגון בעגלים. So a wolf and other prey animals in his size have drasa only for small animals, בהמה דקה. But they don't have the drasa to a big animal, like ox. Now you can say, what about a calf? Calf, you say? Like the calf. Yeah, the baby cow, egel. So the Shulchan Aruch says, even a wolf cannot make even a calf to be drusa. Yeah. But he can make drusa to a small animal, like a sheep or a goat. Afilu begdola shebadakot, even a big animal of the behemah daka can become to be drusa because of an attack of a wolf. So if there is sometimes you have a sheep that can be very, very big, yeah, much more than a cow's calf, but still the wolf can make the sheep to be drusa and not the calf, even though the sheep is bigger than the calf. Yeah. Okay, maybe before we continue, let's see Beritev. Okay, Beritev Aleph, Azev. כתב השח, כיוון שהרבה פוסקים אוסרים בזהב אפילו בבמה גסה, לפי זה אחד אפשר למחור לעבוד כוכבים בלא הפסד, יש למחרו ואסור לשחותו. So the שח says that there was many rabbis that they said that the wolf can make even בבמה גסה to be דרוסה. So if you have a case like that you have a cow that was attacked by a wolf, scratched it, so then you, according to Shulchan Aruch, it is permitted. But says the Shach, it's better to sell it to a non-Jew if you're not losing a lot of money. It's better not to rely on the Shulchan Aruch in that and to get rid of it and to find yourself a different animal that will be more kosher lematrin. Okay? Beritev bet ba'agalim. כתב השחד, יש פוסקים כתבו בעגלים הרכים, ואין להם סימן למד ה', סימן למד ת', יש להחמיר במקום שאין הפסד מרובה, למחור לעובד כוכבים. Okay. So again, also the second paragraph of the Beritev is basically the same continuation of the first one, that when, specifically when you're talking about calf, so there is poskim that he said, like small calves, but the Shach says, in any case, you have to be stringent and to sell it to a non-Jew. אפל פי שצריך לזלזל קצת דמי המחירה, and even if you have to lower the price of the animal, so you lose a little bit of money, חייב למורו, still you have to sell it, okay? ולאב אחי, יש פוסקים, מסרו בזה ואפילו בגסה, because there is the opinions that say that even a big animal can become to be drusa by a wolf. OK. כתב היטב, עכשיו אנו נוהגים לאסור דרוסת הזאב, אפילו בגסה, כדאי את התוספות. Okay, so that's basically the rule for our generations, that we are stringent in a cow or calf that got scratched by a wolf, so we don't permit it. שער פרח כתבו איכה דאפשר למחרו לעובד כוכבים, ולא הפסד מרובה, יש למחרו, ואסור לשחותו. So, מה אתה עושה? So, it brings the Bach that says that we have to be stringent. כתב ופרח כתבו איך עד אפשר למחרו לעובד כוכבים ולא הפסד מרובה, יש למחרו ואסור לשחותו. Okay, if you can sell it to a non-Jew without losing a lot of money, you have to do that, and you cannot do shechit on that. Okay?
That's a wolf, right?
Yeah. Okay? Okay, so I'm going back to the Shulchan Aruch. Chatul v'nemiya v'shu'al. Okay, so now we're going to the small prey animals. So you have a cat, nemiya, I think it's a weasel, but I'm not sure, and a fox, okay? אין להם דריסה בכבשים גדולים, אבל יש להם דריסה בגדיים וטלאים. They don't have, they cannot affect a big animals, even בהמה דקה, which when they are big, but they can do דריסה for small בהמה דקה. So a goat kid or a sheep kid can become to be trefa because of a scratch of a cat. Okay? Shkol shekin mikol ha'ofot, and for sure all of the birds. Chulda, no, chulda is a weasel. So what is nemiya? I'm not sure exactly what is the English name for that.
I'm not sure, but maybe
no.
Is it maybe like a leopard? Is that possible?
Leopard?
No. Not a sow. Very small. It's like a cat, but a big cat. Tall. It's a yoter aroch.
Long. It's like kmo ari?
Kmo chatul. Kmo chatul yoter aroch. Kmo yoter aroch.
A leopard or a cheetah?
No, not cheetah. No.
Doesn't matter. Forget about it. Just there is like different kinds of there is different kinds of those small prey animals. So the nemiya is affecting the kids of the sheep and goat, and chulda, which is a weasel, אין לה דריסה בבהמה כלל, אפילו בגדיים ודליים. So it cannot affect any animal, even kids. אבל יש לה דריסה בכל העופות. But it can make דריסה for all of the birds. אפילו בגסה שלהם, even the big birds. Okay? אפילו בגסה שלהם. כלב אין לו דריסה כלל, אפילו בעופות. A dog doesn't have the law of drasa, even though a dog can be a prey animal, but it doesn't make a drasa. Im nikav ad halal, if there is a hole, if the dog made a hole in the animal or the bird, all the way to the space inside of the body. דינו כקוט שנקרב לחלל. It's like a thorn that came in to the body. שאר חיות מאוד, כל שאינה גסה מהזאב, אין לה דריסה בגדולה. Other prey animals, if it is not bigger than a wolf, so it will not make דריסה in a big animal, שבדקה, בגדולה שבדקה. Big animal of the behemah daka, kvasim ve'izim, sheep or goats. Afilu igasa kezev, even if it is big like a wolf. אבל יש לו דרסה בגדיים ודליים, but it will have the דרסה for the kids on the of the of the goats and sheep. כל שכן בעופות, how much more so about birds. ואם הייתה גסה מהזאב, if it is thicker than a wolf, דינה כזאב, the law is like a wolf. ויש לה דריסה בדקה, אבל לא בגסה. It have the דרסה for the small animal, but not for the big animal. אפילו היא גדולה כארי, even if it is big like a lion. הייתה גסה יותר מארי, if it is bigger than a lion, הרי כארי, it is like a lion, ויש לה דרסה בכל, so it has a דרסה for any animal. אוקיי? רמה, יש מחמירים מאוד, the כל שהיא מזאב ולמעלה, there is those that are stringent, that in any case that is bigger than wolf, like wolf and bigger, יש לה דריסה אפילו במה גסה. To count it like a lion that can make any animal even במה גסה to be דרסה, ויש לה חוש לחומרה, and we have to be to have the to fear that stringency. במה גסה
is the animal that hunts?
במה גסה is it could be, but usually when we say במה גסה we're talking about cows and like buffaloes and like things like that, yeah. Okay. We have one by Ritev Gimel. למעלה כתב השח, אבל זאב עצמו, לא. Wolf itself not so. גם יש להחמיר בדוב ונמר, the דרסי בבהמה גסה. We have to be stringent about a bear and a tiger that they can make also בהמה גסה. דרסה. מי הוא למחרו לעובד גרבים? פשיטה דשארי. To sell it to a non-Jew, for sure it will be permitted. אבל בדקה אסור, זה לא גרע מזאב. But in a small animal it will be forbidden, because it is not less than a wolf. ודווקא לחומר חיישינם, and we are fear the stringency side, ולא לכולה, but not to the lenient side. כאון כיסוי דם. So for the purpose of doing כיסוי דם, we cannot be stringent about it. We have to be lenient, meaning we have to be stringent not to say the barakah of kisui adam. In other words, kaim alayna shochet atarifa patur mikisui. Someone that is doing shchita for a tarifa, he doesn't have to do kisui adam. Chen l'inyan matanot im tafas hakohen o nosin miyado. Okay, so about matanot kiuna, if the kohen took his matanot kiuna, you cannot take it out of his hands. Okay? So for those that doesn't know about what is matanot kiuna, there is many, many things in the Torah that Hashem tells us, when you do that, you have to give a certain present to the Kohen. Okay? One of them is when we're doing shchita of animals, we have to give the cheek with the tongue, and the zroa, which is the end of the front leg, and the keva, which is part of the stomach, to the kohen. Okay, there's three parts in the kohen that is the matanot kiuna. We have a whole siman, few simanim on that, but so not right now. It's not a subject. I just want to explain it. The kohen is like the owner of those things. So if I did shchita, and I say this animal is trefa, so I don't have to do matanot kiuna. Yeah, but the kohen, he didn't ask me, and he went there and he took the matanot kiuna. Yeah, so now can I take it out of him and to sell it with the rest of the animal to the non-Jew? The answer is no, I cannot take it out of him, because I am stringent not to eat the animal and I want to sell it. But he can say, who says it's trefa? Prove that it's trefa. You cannot prove. So it's mine. I'm the owner of the matanot kiuna. Okay, it's a big subject matter, but it's an interesting point. It's more about a mandatory kind of laws of mamonos. When someone is grabbing something, and there is a side that he's the owner, so you cannot take it out of him, even though he grabbed it. Okay? That's part of that. It's okay. the same sugya like the Tekfokoe, yes. Okay.
Mangos.
Okay, mangos. So Nemiya is mangos. Okay, fine. Anyhow, we'll hold it here. Tomorrow we will continue to speak about the drasa of birds. Be'ezrat Hashem, Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen ve'amen. Thank you very much.